Was this decision about regional Australia, or was it because Barnaby wanted his old job back?
No, it's about Australia as a whole. It's about all of those Australians who sometimes don't think they get their voice heard here, sometimes they get ignored or they feel that they're derided. Barnaby's always been a champion for them. And yes, he has his flaws, but who of us doesn't? And he's an authentic and genuine voice for them. So that's what all this was about. I mean, I suppose, when you ask a question like that, speak about my own decision and mindset. And, you know, this is a position I held for 18 months. I gave up my own job because I thought it was the right idea, and I'm not looking for a job because I genuinely am focused on fighting for the hard-working men and women of this country who have jobs and industries that just are so often put down, ignored, like the coal industry, like our manufacturing industries. And I know Barnaby's going to be someone who takes up that fight for them.
But why was Michael McCormack not the right fit, given that he says yesterday that he achieved more for regional Australia and got more spending for regional Australia than ever before?
Look, he did do a lot. And I want to say today everybody saw the integrity and class of Michael, and no one questioned his work ethic. And he did achieve a lot, especially navigating Australia through some very difficult times with the coronavirus. And he's a valuable member of the Nationals Party team. I hope very much he stays on past the next election. He's a great member for Riverina, been a great minister, done a lot of good work as Deputy Prime Minister. But, you know, without labouring these things, I mean, we've had a position in the party room on net zero emissions for some time, and it seemed to come as news to the country, that position last week. Keith Pitt rightfully espoused our position as a room, and everyone was shocked by it. It shouldn't take 6 months for that to come out, and we need to make sure that we do make our own views clear, because if we don't do that, our people will be left behind. So they won't be involved in those decisions.
I do want to ask you about that, but just first on yesterday, what were the conditions or terms of Barnaby Joyce's reappointment?
What do you mean by there's no terms or conditions? The only condition on Barnaby's appointment is that he has a majority support of the Nationals Party room.
OK. What was the tally in the end?
I don't know. We don't announce that, nor do we announce it to the room, so I just don't know. So.
OK. Is it a non-starter, net zero emissions by 2050 for Glasgow?
Well,
is that a non-starter for you?
As Barnaby said yesterday, this is a policy that will be determined by the Nationals Party room going forward. I can only speak to what our position's been to this date. And to this date, we have not been supportive of that policy because of its potential impact on the people we represent.
What about carve-outs?
It's a bit hard to go for a rule-in, rule-out here, but I think a lot of the discussion about net zero emissions is incredibly vague and not very well specified or defined. It's very easy to say, yeah, let's go for net zero emissions, and no-one's against us reducing our carbon emissions. Mm. Sure, that is in the Prime Minister's right. Preferably, let's get to net zero emissions. That'd be great. But preferably, I'd like to lose another 5 kilos. You know, preferably, I'd like to have more money in my bank account. We've got to also know what the costs of achieving any preferable outcome are, and they aren't clear yet. The modelling hasn't been done. It's not clear exactly what net zero would mean. It seems to me that net zero emissions is a glib line used by a lot of countries who are not meeting their existing commitments, so they can distract everybody by talking about something in 30 years' time. Well, I think we're best as a country when we look at pragmatic and practical things.
But then
if you
don't have that commitment, though, aren't you going to get tariffs from European trading partners?
Yeah, there's a lot of talk about that, but, I mean, I don't see any evidence that they... I mean, if they were to do that, they'd better apply them to their own countries in Europe too, because there's countries in Europe that aren't meeting their own commitments. Mm. Are they going to do that? I don't think so.
OK. Are you expecting an early election?
I think that's obviously a matter for the Prime Minister, but I've always believed the Prime Minister when he says he wants to go the full term. I think that's always best for countries. If there are other circumstances, obviously that can make a difference. But, you know, I think it's absolutely right that right now what we need to focus on as a country is rolling out the vaccine, which has had its hurdles, it's had its challenges. We've got to get that going. Then we've got to reopen. And then, even right now, what I think yesterday's decision is also about is making sure we put Australians and Australia first, that we have to restore our manufacturing strength. We've got to keep selling off our land. We've got to make sure we stop sending jobs overseas, because we're in very difficult times and we've got to make sure we're strong as a nation.
Fuel storage.
Well, that's part of it. The government's doing great work on that, but obviously there's a lot more to do.
OK. Just back on Barnaby, do you believe that there could be a women problem?
Well, look, I mean, it's that's for the voters to judge. As I know there's commentary on it, I understand that. As I said before, Barnaby's not a perfect human being. None of us are. I don't put myself forward as one. But I do, you know, make the point that last time I looked at it, New England had about... His seat of New England had about 50% of the electorate being women. And he was returned with a massive majority. There's not a lot of quantitative evidence for this. Notwithstanding, obviously, people are understandably going to have their own views about Barnaby. He is someone that... that people, you know and some people don't like him, some people do, but at least you know where he stands, right? At least you know he's an authentic individual. You take him as he is, and you're never going to be left wondering what his views are on issues. He's very passionate.
Is there a succession plan now?
Oh, I don't think there's anything in particular, but Barnaby spoke yesterday about the fact that, you know, he's obviously towards the end of his time rather than the beginning, and he wants to make sure he does leave the party in good shape. We need to look at that, of course.
What are you going to do?
Mate, I'm very happy being a senator for Queensland.
Are you?
Yes, I am. I this is a great honour, and I know people sometimes hear that with a view of cynicism and scepticism, but I am. I really enjoy it, and that's what I want to keep doing. I'm putting myself up for re-election next year, and if I am, I'll keep fighting
it's
for Queensland.
Not a portfolio you're interested in?
No, not at all. I'm my only portfolio mystery is a senator for Queensland. We've got a great state, and we're going to win on Sunday night.